songs in the land. I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
Hold it!
So what was he doing outside? It's against licensing regulations to drink on the sidewalk.
Esther and Lorna were having a fight. The owner made him take it outside. It was pretty ugly.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah. Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
Hold it!
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy?
Leroy Sabo? The owner?
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you gonna tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm gonna need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
You get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks.
Looks like we caught a break on this one.
There when it happened, but then left the scene.
You're right. That's pretty unusual behavior.
She could be in shock. I saw some people do some strange things in the war after their buddies died.
Maybe she doesn't give a fuck. According to the patrons, her old man was a piece of work. You don't think Phelps, the guy, was run over? So it worked out well for this broad. So what? Maybe she deserved to catch a break. Who knows?
Officers help. Major 415, 1624 West 3rd Street, 1624 West 3rd Street.
Finally. We're starting to think nobody would show.
What have we got?
The 3rd Street Gang and the Diamond Street Gang. Mexican kids with nothing better to do than howl at each other. But no bloodshed so far. Shit! Hope you brought plenty of ammunition, sir.
LAPD, drop your weapons. Throw out the guns.
Car 11K calling KGPL. I need an ambulance at 1624 West 3rd Street. Code 4. Shots fired and suspects are down.
Roger on the ambulance, 11K. All units be advised, code 4 on the major 415 on West 3rd Street. Suspects are down.
You're behind the wheel.
Yes? Hello?
Mrs. Patterson.
Is this about my husband?
We're investigating the incident, ma'am.
I see. Come in, won't you?
Can you tell me what happened?
What's to tell? He got hit by a car and now he's dead.
You don't appear to be too upset about the fact.
Lester and I met on a furlough in 44. We got married that weekend. People don't understand it now, but that happened a lot back then.
I see. So you probably did well to stick it out this long.
What's that supposed to mean, mister? I think it's about time you left. I have someone here, and
I beg your pardon? You're gonna have to run that one by us again, sister.
It's okay, Lorna. I'm Leroy Sabo.
Well, well. Nice to see you're comforting the grieving widow, Mr. Sabo.
All right, wise guy. Do you have any intelligent questions you would like me to answer?
You can confirm Mrs. Patterson's story.
Lester lost at cards. He was kind of hard to control when he lost his temper. He turned without looking and walked right out in front of the car. It wasn't good.
What's your relationship with Mrs. Patterson, Mr. Sabo?
We're friends. Good friends.
You expect me to believe that?
Look, I was filing for divorce. Mental cruelty. Lester could be a mean son of a bitch.
And Lester knew about that?
No. I hadn't told him.
Well, hasn't this worked out well for the two of you? I feel almost bad for busting in on this little rendezvous.
How did the car come to hit Lester?
He walked straight into the path of an oncoming car.
Hold it!
You expect me to believe that, Laura? It's all very convenient.
Gambling for Lester was like the needle for a hophead. He was yelling at me. He was yelling at the whole world. I kind of felt sorry for the driver. Poor guy had no chance.
You were arguing in the bar and on the sidewalk?
We were always arguing. So what?
Hold it!
Admit it. You were baiting him, pushing his buttons. We can easily get the full story from the regulars in the bar.
All right. Lester was playing cards out back. He lost, of course, and wanted back in. He suggested I earn the money on my back to get a mistake. That was the proposition he was putting to his so-called buddies. So maybe I was a little angrier than usual. Let's just say I took exception to his idea.
The bartender said that you and Leroy were planning to go into business together. Can you explain how you'll get the money to do that?
I have a little money saved away.
Objection!
You're being economical with the truth, Lorna.
You want to back that up, little man?
You increased the premium on Lester's life insurance. GI insurance policies have a $10,000 payout.
It was Leroy's idea. Lester lived on the edge. He was always getting into fights, crap games, pinochle, you name it. Turns out it was good advice.
It speaks to motive and premeditation, Lorna.
You're forgetting the hit-and-run detective.
You and Mr. Sabo have an interesting day.
I'm sure we will, officer. Now, if you could both just leave...
We're leaving, ma'am. Sorry for your loss. I can see what a tough time you're having with all this.
Listening to Duke Ellington on KTI.
Right there. William Shelton?
Yes?
It doesn't look good, Shelton. You packing your bags and making a run for it? You know why we're here.
Yes. The accident.
We've got witnesses who can put this car at the scene, not to mention the physical damage. This is open and shut, Shelton.
That coward thinks he can run from everything.